Mary Simpson on violin. And Gabriel Vivas on the bass.
Of all the forces that have exerted on us over our lifetime, at least for me, love has been the most powerful of all. As our population increases, our planet becomes smaller and smaller. It's therefore very important that we all learn how to love and accept each other. Whenever that's not possible, at least learn how to tolerate one another. I learned that very valuable lesson early on in life because of changing cultures. I moved from Greece to the United States, and to this day, people ask me, are you Greek or are you American? I'm a human being, just like all of us. And then I am Greek or American or Chinese or Indian. You must come to understand and realize that there are as many ways to live life as there are people on this planet. 2,500 years ago, Socrates said that the perfect human being is all human beings put together. It is a collective. It is a we. It is all of us together that make perfection. The next piece of music talks all about that. And I would like to dedicate it to Shah Jahan and Mumtaz Mahal and to the architects and engineers and sculptors that loved the pieces of marble into this architectural wonder of beauty we call the Taj Mahal. And also, I would like to dedicate it to all the people in India who loved this concert into existence and thus enabling us to send a very powerful and much needed message around the world, a message of love, unity, acceptance, and tolerance. The song will begin once again with our Venezuelan friend Pedro Eustache playing a 2,500-year-old Armenian instrument called the duduk. It's called Love Is All.
Ooh. Mm-hmm. Johnson.
The next piece of music, believe it or not, was inspired by a nightingale. I often listen to nature because I learn balance from listening to nature. I remember a few years ago I was in Venice, Italy, and one of these birds kept coming by my window every sunset, and she proceeded to sing her song. And it was so beautiful, I was completely mesmerized by it. These birds have such a tremendous vocabulary and rhythms and melodies. And I thought, what a pity that we couldn't communicate, we couldn't speak each other's language. It wasn't until many years later, when I was introduced to the Chinese flute, that I realized that this instrument, particularly in the higher registers, has a lot of the tonal characteristics of the nightingale. And so I decided to write a song using the Chinese flute. The song will begin with our Venezuelan friend, whom you met a little earlier tonight, Pedro Eustache, playing the Chinese flute. It's called Nightingale, and I'd like to dedicate it to you. Thank you. Wohen Gao Xing Dao Beijing Lai. And this is all the Chinese I know for now. But I promise when I come back next year I would have learned a lot more. It is indeed a great honor for me to be performing in the Forbidden City. It is one of the greatest architectural achievements in the world, and it is perhaps man's attempt to imagine heaven on earth. For the past few weeks I have been touring China, and I have been deeply moved by the warmth and by the acceptance of the Chinese people. And I know that when I returned home, I would have been changed by my experiences in China. So, we will continue now with a new composition. This one is called Renegade.
Thank you. Pedro Eustache on saxophone and flute. And Karen Griggs on violin.
Thank you.
Luis Aquino on trumpet.
Of all the forces that have exerted on us over our lifetime, at least for me, love has been the most powerful of all. As our population increases, our planet becomes smaller and smaller. It's therefore very important that we all learn how to love and accept each other. And whenever that's not possible, at least learn how to tolerate one another. I learned that very valuable lesson early on in life because of changing cultures. I moved from Greece to the United States, and to this day, people ask me, are you Greek or are you American? I'm a human being, just like all of us. And then I'm Greek or American or Chinese or Indian. You must come to understand and realize that there are as many ways to live life as there are people on this planet. 2,500 years ago, Socrates said that the perfect human being is all human beings put together. It is a collective. It is a we. It is all of us together that make perfection. The next piece of music talks all about that. And I would like to dedicate it to Shah Jahan and Mumtaz Mahal, and to the architects and engineers and sculptors that loved the pieces of marble into this architectural wonder of beauty we call the Taj Mahal. And also, I would like to dedicate it to all the people in India who loved this concert into existence and thus enabling us to send a very powerful and much needed message around the world, a message of love, unity, acceptance, and tolerance. The song will begin once again with our Venezuelan friend Pedro Eustache playing a 2,500-year-old Armenian instrument called the duduk. It's called Love Is All. Ooh. Mm-hmm.
Ram Johnson.